Hi there, it's Arian. Today we want to explore the terrain shader module from the Vegetation Engine. Check out the previous video, which was about the blanket and TV. The terrain shader module is part of the Vegetation Engine. It's important to note that the latest version of the Vegetation Engine is required for these modules to work. The terrain shaders module is an advanced terrain shader solution with up to 16 layers supported. Height-based blending and per-layer planar, triplanar and stochastic mapping. It has integration with the Vegetation Engine global season, overlay, wetness, emissive and height offset for snow or tracks. I have installed the terrain shader in the boxophobic directory. Another folder named Vegetation Engine modules is created. Let's open a demo scene from a terrain. This scene is preset, so there is no need for adjustments. Terrain game object has a script called TVE train, which will send the terrain data to the material. If the terrain or the terrain layers are modified without selecting the terrain, or they are modified by an external tool, make sure to set the terrain refresh to always. If the height is modified by vertex height elements, you might need to increase the terrain bounds to avoid the terrain culling. I will explain terrain settings later. For now, let's see the terrain material. This material is using the boxophobic, the Vegetation Engine, landscape, terrain standard lit shader. You can tweak stuff like render decals and alpha clipping. In global settings, adjust the layers and control the global color or overlay or others. The terrain supports up to 16 layers, more than what Unity offers. And there are options to optimize texture packing for better performance. You can adjust the terrain color, normal, occlusion, smoothness, and height blend. The per-layer triplanar stochastic or triplanar stochastic options refer to different mapping techniques. Triplanar mapping, this technique is used to texture surfaces without distortion based on the surface orientation. It blends three texture projections from top, side and front based on the surface normal direction. Stochastic mapping introduces randomness into the texture projection, which helps to break up patterns and create more natural looking surfaces. It's often used to add variation to textures like grass, rocks, or terrain. Triplanar stochastic mapping, this combines the benefits of the both triplanar mapping and stochastic mapping. It applies triplanar mapping to each layer of the terrain, while also introducing stochastic variations to each layer's texture. These techniques are commonly used in the terrain shaders to achieve more realistic and visual results by reducing texture distortion and adding natural variations to the terrain's appearance. Season elements are pre-made. We can easily change the season control and see the effects. But in case you don't know how elements works, go and watch the previous video about the Vegetation Engine. The global volume scale covers the entire terrain and element size. Element global colors control the color of seasons, while element global overlay affects only winter, covering the terrain in snow. The element road overlay applies a texture or mass with a winter value of less than 1. Here it is set to 0.2 for reduce the snow coverage. Height offset is a vertex height shader that adjusts the height. For example, a winter value of 1 impacts only winter with a height scale of 0.5. The height noise is the same, it just sets the render mode to constant and it sets the height scale to be 0. We can create any elements and apply them to the terrain. There is a demo scene in blanket shader which uses the terrain shader too, and you can see how smoothly it blends the terrain and rock. Terrain settings will give us the option to override the layer textures and parameters per terrain, or to use custom render textures or render textures with animated effects such as molten lava or animated sand wind, which is not possible by default with the terrain system. These render textures use the custom shader distortion. You can create any shaders you want and assign them. Thanks for watching. The terrain shader offers more, but I won't cover it in this video. It's just a review for today. If you need vegetation for your game, boxophobic packages are one of the best options. Check Game Dev Box for other tips and tutorials. See you next time.